AutoFilter is one of the most powerful modulation tools in music production, enabling us to create fresh new sounds, sweeps and effects by warping existing synths and instruments with a variety of filters, waveforms and resonances. You can access AutoFilter in the latest version of N-Track Studio on Android, iOS, Windows and Mac. Simply update the N-Track Studio app in Google Play or App Store, or download to the latest desktop version from ntrack.com. In this video, we'll be using N-Track Studio 9.6 on Android. The easiest way to open the N-Track AutoFilter is to click the plus icon on the mixer, then AutoFilter. Let's get into it. By default, on the left of the plugin, we can see a graph with some controls. On the right side, we see a single modulated AutoFilter view that consists of a single frequency knob and a waveform shape. Tap it to open the waveforms menu. We can also see some additional settings in the lower part of the effect. To get started, let's hear how the default AutoFilter settings alter a drum beat. Here's the beat before AutoFilter, and here's the same pattern with AutoFilter. The frequency knob controls the filter's cutoff modulation rate. The more you move the knob away from the center, the faster the modulation becomes. We can see that when the knob is set at the center position of 0 Hz, the modulation stops. By moving the control, we can hear that modulation rates between 20 and minus 20 Hz sound more rhythmic, whilst values outside of that range produce more timbral effects. Switching to the interval icon, a precise musical subdivision can be selected. This allows us to create interesting rhythmic patterns that modulate in time with your part or track. Let's listen to a few. Clicking on Sine, the default setting, opens the Waveform Shape menu. Selecting alternative waveform shapes changes the way the filter oscillates, and consequently, the sound of the modulation. Each shape has its own characteristic sound, and a whole video could be done on this only, but in a nutshell, Sine sounds like a pure tone. Square produces a harsher sound and produces jumps in the filter's cutoff. Triangle produces a bright sound, while Saw is more rich and buzzy and also produces jumps in the filter's cutoff. The most interesting controls are those inside the frequency response graph. Moving the horizontal arrows in the graph alter the depth of the modulation. We can hear that by bringing the depth to zero, no oscillation occurs. We're in the off position. As we increase the depth value, we move the highest frequency point that the filter oscillates to. The crosshair icon can be moved left, right, up and down. Adjusting its position on the graph horizontally changes the lowest frequency that the filter oscillates from, say 200 Hz. Moving the crosshair up and down alters the resonance. We can see how this adjusts the slope of the filter. Setting the resonance value changes how aggressively frequencies are boosted or reduced by the curve. Setting the slope value helps us to change how selectively we can cut or boost some frequencies without affecting others. We can see that a larger resonance value results in a narrower curve, whilst a smaller value widens the curve. Narrow and tall shapes create a more dramatic effect. Only when the peaking and band shapes are selected can we control the gain setting. Press and drag the vertical arrows to affect the gain of the curve. Dragging up boosts the gain value in decibels and exaggerates the effect of the filter, whilst dragging down reduces the frequency selected by the curve. While you're dragging the arrows, the gain value in decibels can be read in the bottom left corner of the graph. So let's play around with the three controls and get things sounding interesting. To change the band shape from the default bandpass, tap on the band shape box in the plugin. A menu with all the available shapes will appear. Note that high and low pass shapes are named for the frequencies they leave untouched, rather than the frequency range they cut. When the envelope or reverse envelope shapes are selected, the frequency knob will disappear, and in its place you'll see the attack and release knobs, which alter the behavior of the envelope. In these modes, AutoFilter no longer modulates regularly based on a waveform. Instead, it follows the input signal and changes its filter according to changes in the signal's volume. The attack setting adjusts the rate of change between the maximum filter frequency and the bass cutoff. The release knob sets the time it takes for the EQ to return to the resting position when the signal amplitude decreases, i.e. the bass cutoff. If manual is selected, we can see that there is no oscillation and hear that no modulation occurs. In this mode, AutoFilter essentially acts as a one-band EQ, which is sometimes useful, for example, when you want to manually automate it, as we'll show later. Let's click on the plus button below the Waveshape menu. We can see that we now have a second modulation, that is a second frequency control and Waveshape menu. This multiplies the sonic possibilities of AutoFilter, and here's how it works. The left frequency control sets the cutoff of the left oscillator, and the output of that oscillator is then multiplied by the value of the right frequency control. The result then sets the frequency of the right oscillator, whose output is finally defining the cutoff of the filter. So, in simple terms, two modulations are combined with their separate outputs multiplied together, and that creates more complex and diverse sound design and modulations. Let's get ready for the chaos. Unlike the previous and more structured views in AutoFilter, once the feedback loop is activated, random behaviors are generated. That is, behaviors that aren't predictable through simple patterns or structure. Additional resonances can be added from the resonances menu. The higher the number of resonances, the more peaks are introduced, as shown in the graph. These extra peaks will enrich the sound, but also create different movements because they move in opposite directions when the frequency is modulated. Using the factory presets are a great way to get started quickly in AutoFilter. Try them out and then tweak and modify the settings to your taste. Let's hear a few examples. We can also automate AutoFilter parameters to create morphing and dynamic filter changes. With a faster interval, band shelf and the saw wave selected, we'll enable the record envelopes icon, which is visible in the plugin, and play our track. We'll then progressively increase the depth factor on the graph as the track plays back. Once complete, we can see the parameter movement has been captured and will then be played back automatically. We have a specific video which goes into more detail on automation. You can check that out at the top of the video. We've only shown the tip of the iceberg as to what AutoFilter can do, but we hope that this gives you an idea about how you can use it to create a wide array of different modulations that can add movement and enrich your projects. Do let us know if any questions or comments come up when trying AutoFilter out, and as ever, if you could please give this video a like, subscribe so we can keep the channel growing, and ding that notification bell so you know when our next video is out, that would be fab. Until next time, have fun making music with N-Track. Cheers.